Hello guys, and welcome to a new Let's Play on Grower's Farm. So we are going to go and fetch some water. We don't have a water pump, and I've been told that there is free water if you go to the river. So this Let's Play is, we own the farm, but we also own a contracting business called JB Agri Contractors. They are on Facebook. So we've got a lot of tractors at the farm. We've also got a new tractor, a couple of new tractors and bits and bobs at the dealership to pick up. I got told that if you come down here, there's an entrance point or something that you can go in and take it. Pretty certain it's that where that pump is. There. That's fine. So we're just gonna get, yeah, we're just gonna get water. From here, we're on the 8340, two-wheel drive. But yeah, it's good water, clear water. How much does that just cost me? Nothing. So that's free water. So if I need any more water, because we've got sheep, we've got 50 sheep. So I've got to take one of the tractors off the trailer, because we are carting wheat today. I'll take one of them off, stick it on a, well, it's got a front loader on it, so we're going to be using that, unless I, it's got pallet tines at the thingy for the low telehandle handle, so I might jump on the class scorpion. So in this Let's Play I'm also a collector of classic tractors. So in some, in one of my sheds I have some very nice tractors, but they are also, they're not on the farm to stay, to just stand about and do nothing. They're on the farm to work, to earn the keep basically. Brought this tractor from a sale, dairy farm sale. It was on the straw blower. But it's now on water bowser, and on the straw blower when we get the sheep, when we get the cows, which we are pretty soon. We've also got some machines at the back, so I'll show you around the farm just when we've sorted the sheep out, because I need the, yeah, there's a loader, so I'll take the bucket off. I thought I'd left this gate open. So we've also got to sort that bit out, because that is actually a gateway. So, oh, they've got hay. Right. Okay. And they've got more, but they're having water now. So, yeah. It's fine for the moment. So that's just staying on that for a bit. I'm going to go take the bucket off and I'll do a tour around the farm when I come back. Just going to take this off. So we've moved, well, we've sold one of the farms, and that will be, which farm that will be announced pretty soon. So yeah, we're harvesting a wheat field at the moment, but we've got plenty of bales, so they're going to keep, we're going to stack them in the field. I'm going to see how high I can stack. So yeah, we're going to see what we can do. We have actually brought this over from our rubber farm that we sold. So yeah, we're not. We haven't. And we've moved all the straw bales and hay bales over. And we've made grass bales. We found a load of grass bales in one of the sheds at the old farm, so we brought them over. They'll be good for the sheep, because we can also give them so that's my new toy. It's just having some stuff done to it, and that is JB Agric's new chopper for 2020. Got rid of the crone, we've got rid of, no we haven't, we haven't got rid of the crone, we've got rid of the other one, the New Holland, we had a New Holland, got rid of that and brought a class, because we have run class Jaguars in the past, and we've really liked them, but the New Holland at the time, there was a better deal. Yeah, there's a better deal for the New Holland chopper, but we swapped it. We didn't pay out actually, it was just a straight swap. Took it down to the dealership. They evaluated it and to see how much it was worth. And because we have mechanics on the farm, everything was sound. Had a check, had a service. So we have got quite a lot of money, but that doesn't mean I'm going to be spending it all on the tractors and the choppers and that. I'm going to try and spend it on land, so we have more land to work. I brought two fields up there. Brought the field where we are combining. I've also brought a new combine, so we'll see that in a bit. And I need bales. What do I need? I need grass bales. No, I don't need hay. So, here it is our stack that I've been unloading. I know you would normally do this with a bale forks, but we have automatic bale forks at the moment, and I don't want to wreck the stack. So I hope everyone's having a good day. This should go out. It'll be a half an hour video. It'll be a 10-minute video, but I'll try and cut it down. But yeah, they've had water. They've got grass here now. I don't know if you can pick this up. I don't really want to pick. Nope, you can't. So what we're going to do is we're going to get some jobs done today in the yard. There's some things I want to sort out. And also a tour I want to get done. So this is a sheep yard. Sheep shed. There's the Ford with the Droskin. Also got a round baler that may be going because we may be having a coon baler. It's also got a wrapper on the side. We've got a black coon mower there, I think. Then this is the, there's the grass bales, got a bit of a yard there, just for anything that we need to. I'm just taking you around on the Scorpion, because I'm on it, so I'll just turn this off while we got a slurry tanker, an Abbey slurry tanker, 250 gallon. We've got a 2,500 gallon major tanker. Then we've got two Bailey trailers, 16 ton. They'll be doing the maize silage, carting manure. And then we've got And then we've got a Flegal bale trailer with auto load on it. So when we're doing big jobs, we don't have to bring the Scorpion. We just take the tractor with us. We've got a Chiffon low loader. We've got two of these actually. One of them is currently on the new field because we've just been sorting some trees that have been overhanging. Then we've got a Samsung SP14 muck spreader, rear discharge. That goes on our 6155M, which you will see in a bit. Also, the Major goes on the 6155M. So you'll see some of our machines. We own that field, this field, that field over there. Anything in that? No, then you got the hay and the straw there. Then we've got the car over there that's been swapped. What have we got in here? Oh, then we've got the Viking Fan X 604 Tedder, which will go on the Ford when it's doing a bit of hay making. And here is the drill that is being, well, it's being kept, but we are having a couple more big drills. There's a dairy yard, the baler, the coon baler, and the coon tedder. So I think that's a 9 meter tedder. Then we've got the Silo King feeder wagon. That is staying, but that is going to be used as straw blower. Then this was the stock tractor, so that's why it's got a front loader on it, because it was meant to do the stock feeding, but it's been called on trailer job, so we've got Scorpion doing this job. So this is our, well, these are our grain bins. So all the grain we'll unload it in here, and then it'll go, get it there on them. So there's four big grain bins here. Then we've got turn that off. Then we've got, what we've got in here, because I have no idea. Oh, we've got a plough that is going. The Salford plough that's going, and then we've got this, an Amazon disc harrow that is actually staying. The plough is going because we need one that can swing over, so it's got reversible. So yeah, we're not gonna do much. And then we've got the bucket for the Scorpion. So this is the workshop / toy shed. I'll just stick this. So we've got, if I can walk through them, we've got 2 7 8 10s, which JBI Brick started their we started the contracting company 10 years ago with 7 8 10s. One of them is actually the original one that we brought for JBI Brick, but I actually don't know which one. Then we've got the fence. Is it 820 Vario TMS? Which is the same as the X stock tractor out there. Then we've got a 7810, which did the butt raking for a couple of years, but is now, I don't know what that is actually, what that's here for, but it's here and it's staying. Then we've got the John Deere 6155M that goes on the slurry tanker and the muck spreader. Then we've got a John Deere 3350, which actually hasn't been long with the farm, well, with the company. It was a couple of months it's been, but we brought it off a collector that had too many of these. I think he had about 6 3350s, and he wanted to get rid of them. Well, a couple of them he wanted to get rid of, and this one was. Kept it in immaculate condition. It's never done any work, but it has done work for us. Where's it from? D. It's like Denmark. Okay. Then we got a Fendt 724 Vario with the chrome Fendt exhaust cover. It's a bit mucky because it's actually been doing a bit of emptying the water up at the bit where we went to collect it, because it was a bit messy. So what we're gonna do now, we'll jump on the fence and we'll head up to the farm. Well, we'll head up to the field to see more of our equipment. And there's a there's a story why we've got two of the same. I was at the dealership, and we were looking for a stock tractor for this farm, because we weren't going to buy a Scorpion. We were going to just use a front loader tractor for the time being, and this was being reduced because it's Christmas. So they were like, would you want this? I was like, well, yeah. It was the only tractor at the time because we were moving farms, so I tried to move the sheep over first. We did have to sell some, but yeah. So here is So we've got the, well, we got the new fast track on the other Sheepin trailer with the new forestry equipment, which literally chews, which the front bit, you turn it on, you go into a tree and it literally just demolishes it. So we've cleared some of that bit up there, so it's fine now. So I can see that our new combine is ready to be unloaded, so he's doing pretty well actually. This new combine is, it's got a new header on it, it hasn't actually got a class header on. It's got a, I'll jump off now in a minute, see if I can get around quickly enough. It's got a crescent header engineered in Italy. It's basically a fold up one, so we don't have to put a header trailer on it. 7.2 meters, it's easier for us because we can keep it on the combine at all times. We can also keep the one on the New Holland on, because that's only a small one. But the New Holland may be going soon. Well, it may be replaced by another one of them. Then we've got, so we've got red, we've got two Red Rock trailers. And we've got a Mass Ferguson 7726S on, well, this will be the hauling job today. I'll turn this combine around and I've got to take the fast track back down to the farm. So I think we're going to get baling today. So I'm going to try and get a bit of baling done. I don't know if two. Because I need to pull one of the tractors out if I'm going to do what I'm thinking of doing. So I've been watching recently a lot of George Sanders videos. He, well, drives fast tracks, he drives fence, I think he drives deers as well, but he also drives well, it drives DCB low loaders. That's right. Right. There's a thingy of my name, Jack442, and that is because I really like these fast tracks, the 442 series. That is why my name is Jack4220. Possibly getting an 8000 model when the farm grows and we've got enough jobs for it. But at the moment we haven't got enough jobs for the 8000, so we are putting this in that little gap, in that little shed over there, So, yeah, just like now, we're just getting ready, because I'm gonna go back up with this and the rake, if I can get, yes, we'll put it where the, so yeah, we're on the fast track today. Thank you. So we are just doing bailing. Well, we're not bailing. The fenters, we're just rowing two sets of lines up into one, so he doesn't have to go up and down the field 3 or 4 times. These bales won't be coming to the farm. These bales will be sold. We just need we just need to speak to somebody. Just to see if they want them. And if they don't, then we'll just sell them to Straw. Sell point. So yeah, we'll try and get this done. See how many bales we are gonna get. So yeah, we are just baling. Well, we're not baling, but we are making straw bales. We're gonna get up to the fence where the fence is, and then we're gonna clear that. So yeah, we're not gonna we're gonna end the video there. So thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe, and as always, bye for now.